Hey, does I just thought of something, but the hepatologist is a liver specialist. The liver is sort of the body's filter, and then these new vacuum cleaners, they have the HEPA filter.
Yeah.
Does the HEPA mean anything, or is that just some sort of acronym and it's a coincidence?
Let's give it the dictionary. Let's see.
Oh, for Christ's sake. Mike, stall for about 20 minutes. Let me... It's an acronym?
No,
all right, go ahead. Look up HEPA, would you?
Have you ever heard about a vaginecologist?
No.
It's similar to a gynecologist in many ways.
No.
No?
No.
I was just wanting to know because I figured you're a professional.
But a herpetologist.
Hmm.
They have herpetologists?
Is...
Study of herpes?
No, it's like...
Study of plant eating... herpetologists?
Herpetologists.
Is it a study of like plant eating dinosaurs or something?
Look it up for you.
Nicole.
Yeah, hi.
You're 17. We sort of want to make this show a learning experience, but not really.
Right.
Dealing with reptiles and amphibians. That's what it is.
Okay.
Why?
Study of herpetologist.
Yeah.
Study of reptiles. Somebody who studies it.
Yeah, didn't I say that? Sort of?
What'd you say?
Well, I said herpetologist.
You said herpes. You said plant.
You said herpetologist. What's it say? How do you spell it?
H-E-R-P-E-T-O-L-O-G-Y. It's a branch of zoology. Dealing with amphibians.
All right, I was closer than you were, Jackal.
You can't look up vaginecology.
Look up HEPA. Look up HEPA. Nicole?
First time I'll be for the guest.
Go ahead.
Well, you guys are awesome. I listen to you guys every night.
Thank you.
I was wondering, the feeling of excitement during sex, does it, for a girl, does it actually like come from the penis entering the vagina or the clitoris?
Sorry.
We have a female in the studio, so she can speak.
And? You want to? Oh, no. Natasha?
No, I'm not going to say
that. No, don't get graphic. No, oh, please.
There is no need for me to be involved in this one.
You're the female.
I'm the female.
You don't have to talk about your own experience.
What's the question? Do you get the pleasure out of the penis entering or what?
She's wondering if it's clitoral stimulation or vaginal stimulation.
Me and
my friend were talking the other day. Mm-hmm.
This is Opal from Pee Wee's Playhouse.
I know. I'm
freaking out about
violated.
That.
You know, I think the sex part is generally the good part.
Well, what is the good part? I mean, where does it come from? Me and my friend were talking, and she said that it has nothing to do with the penis being inside. It's just like the rubbing of the
penis. Well, yeah, that's what I've heard. I mean, I've heard just because, you know, I'm not very experienced.
What is that like?
It is different for different women. That basically the clitoris is the remnant of what would have become a penis if the Y chromosome had been there. So there's a lot of tissue that can be stimulated in that region, but it can also be stimulated from behind. The vagina is also rich in neurologic material that can be stimulated, more so in some women than others. And it's also part of the experience in a way that is gratifying. It's more gratifying for some women to actually have the intercourse as well.
When you get fingered by a guy, it's not really anything.
Yeah, listen, Nicole, I don't want to burst your bubble, but I mean sexually, but I didn't mean it physiologically. I meant burst your bubble emotionally. I'm going to take a bat to that smoke detector, Nicole. I swear to God, I'm coming over there.
You hear that?
I was just wondering. I have another question.
No, wait. Let's finish
Nicole,
this one.
Hold on.
What?
Nicole.
Huh?
Take that smoke detector down.
Is there a smoke detector in your house that's doing that chirping? Okay, could you go into another room, possibly?
What are you smoking, Nicole?
All right, go into the bathroom.
It's going to echo.
I'd rather hear it echo than hear that smoke detector.
Can you really hear it?
Yes.
Okay.
Hold on one second. Let's examine the question, can you really hear it? Let's just go ahead and break that one down for a second.
Wow.
Yeah, Nicole, I'm going to kill you if you don't get rid of that damn thing that's chirping in the background. Can you hear it?
Can you really hear it?
Good part. Why does it feel good?
She doesn't know where we're... Yeah. We're bluffing. Yeah. All right.
It was a little batty.
Yeah, we got a camera in the air. All right. Nicole?
Yeah.
You don't get a second question for that retarded comment you just made about us hearing it.
When it goes all day?
Hey, listen. Don't you go insane with that thing going off every 10 seconds?
I kind of got used to it. I've been living here for like a year, so...
Oh, Nicole.
Just change the battery. That's all you got to do.
Actually, the manager said that it beeps because it doesn't need a battery.
He's trying to chase you out, I think.
He's gaslighting you, Nicole. He's trying to drive you insane slowly so he can move his in-laws in there. Nicole, is there an adult on the premises?
No, not right now.
Why are you living by yourself?
I'm not living by myself. My father works the graveyard shift.
Where's your mom?
I don't know. In hell, I hope.
Oh, what happened there?
Wow.
Well, she was a big old drug addict, and when I was 7, she had a fit one day on Mother's Day of all days, and she threw my sister and I out because we weren't behaving well enough.
And you were 7?
Yeah, it was a couple months before my 8th birthday.
And your dad got you then, or what?
No, we went through that whole legal system, foster care, bounced from grandma's house to aunt's house to uncle's house for a while, for about 2 years. And then my aunt got me for like a year or two, and then my dad got me for a year or two, and then I got kicked out of school, so I came over here, and I've been living here since.
And when did you lose your hearing?
My hearing?
All right.
We were talking earlier, before we went on the air, about adaptation.
Yeah.
You know, she just screens out the white noise.
So, Nicole, you're 17, but you're a virgin?
No.
No, because the whole virgin thing didn't fit.
But she's not getting any pleasure from sex.
That part fits. For a minute, I was confused and thought somebody from this background hadn't had sex yet, and I realized that was a ridiculous notion from doing this show. When did you lose your virginity?
See, that part, I'm not sure, because, like, when I was 13, me and this guy got into it and stuff, but, like, right when it went in, I told him to stop. And then when I was 15, I actually had the whole...
Deal. Right.
The whole thing.
All right.
I guess.
All right. Nicole?
Mm-hmm.
Number one, get a 9-volt battery for that goddamn smoke detector. Number two, the sex part, here's how it'll settle itself. It's no use working it all out because it's different for everybody.
Well, that's not the issue for her.
It's not the issue anyway.
Yeah.
Find a good guy, use a condom, have a loving relationship, and just work it out.
Wow, can you believe Adams gave that advice? Yeah. I'm so proud of myself. I converted him.
Well, listen, I'm the kind of guy who, like, leave a beer with a cigarette butt floating in it on my nightstand for a week.
Right.
But even I will not leave the smoke detector with the chirping go on for more than half a night. As a matter of fact, I just got up the other night and pulled my one off the ceiling. But the problem is I have two. I got one upstairs and one in the basement. Being the pessimist that I am, when I heard the chirping from inside my bedroom, I got up in my stupor. I walked down the stairs into the basement.
Change that one.
Dismantled the one in the basement, set it down, walked back up, got in bed, laid down, heard the chirping again, and realized it was the one just outside my bedroom door in the hallway. The manager said that meant the battery was fresh.
Doesn't need a battery.
A little
batty. We got to go to break. Okay?
Okay. All right. I'm going to re-examine my life, and we'll be back.